My family has been coming to Point Lonsdale for 5 generations, and a huge majority of my childhood memories are based around the small beachside town. Point Lonsdale has always been a very important place for me. Even to this day, whenever life gets too much, my first thought is always, do I have enough time to drive down to Point Lonsdale for a surf?
I've been holding out for way too long, man, hoping you'll say you're mine. I've been so in doubt, you play along down low and always behind.
Point Lonsdale is a small coastal town on the western tip of Port Phillip Bay. It originally started with just a small area of farmland. However, due to the area's beauty, we fast forward to today and the land has basically reached capacity. Currently, the land behind the town is being developed. However, due to the land being marshy and full of lakes, it is an expensive process. As a result, there is ever-growing pressure to develop the land on the iconic Lighthouse Reserve. There's been a lot of conflict over plans to develop the land, and I wanted to find out why the community was so intent on preserving the Lighthouse Reserve. So I met up with Lester Hunt, and he agreed to take me on a tour of the Lighthouse Reserve to show me why it was so historically significant.
So this was, a 6-inch gun emplacement. The centre was here on this foundation. You can still see some of the steel. And it had a railway track that the gun swiveled round on. You can see a bit of the track still left here. This was the engine shed. The First World War and Second World War, it generated power for the searchlights and all the army emplacements that were around at that time. So it dates back to 1914. So these were World War I searchlight emplacements. This one on the south side and the other one on the east side of the lighthouse. The board rider's shed had the generator, and that powered the searchlights up here.
I didn't see any signage or anything about what it actually was.
Yeah, it's nothing.
It's a lump of concrete. It's just anyone that doesn't know the area.
That no one cares about, because, you know, there's nothing to signify what it was.
Yeah.
But if it had the old photo of the guys operating it in the First, Second World War, and then they would be more respectful, or most would be anyway. This was for targeting. Artillery targeting, and there's a picture with 3 AWAS, Australian Women's Army Service, standing here working this targeting mechanism. This is the foundations of the lighthouse keeper's residence. Both the wooden lighthouse and this were demolished, unfortunately. The wooden lighthouse I can understand, but the residence is such a pity that they knocked that down as well. Looking across the top where you're pointing now is where the original wooden lighthouse was on that rise. So we're on the Toc H site now. This Toc H was originally set up by the Red Cross. I believe it has sort of a Red Cross began the organisation, and they took it over from the Army after the Second World War.
The council has proposed building a high-end spa retreat on the Toc H site to attract more people to the town. I organised to meet with Andrew Sutherland to talk about the details of those plans and how he's been involved in preventing them from happening.
The council's proposals aren't always welcome, and the proposed development for Point Lonsdale Lighthouse Reserve was an example of where a few individuals got it very, very badly wrong. It's perhaps indicative of the fact that, you know, they didn't grow up there, they don't understand the culture of the town, and also I think they didn't understand the heritage values which attach to that particular site. The spa development was just, I think, put in there as a negotiating tactic by the council. It's a very good negotiating tactic to say, well, do you want it big or do you want it really big? And people say, I don't want it really big, I'll take it big. And so people would then settle for the eco cabins. Generally, any time you see a word with eco in front of it, it means it shouldn't be there. Eco cabins is just a bullshit way of people are saying, we're going to smack something right in the middle of the environment that shouldn't actually be there, but we're going to dress it up with a phrase. But clearly people, I think, saw through that and they said, well, we don't want any of that. Does a playground have to be financially viable? Does a footpath have to be financially viable? No, they don't. Of course they don't. I mean, these are the sort of nonsense ideas that are bandied about by people who want to develop, that everything has to have a financial return. Well, that, I'm here to tell you, is just rubbish. Because the area, if it is fixed up properly, will act as a tourist beacon in its own right. So to get our message across, we sat around and we workshopped it, and we set up a Facebook page, and we put a lot of time into naming it, and we named it the Friends of the Point Lonsdale Lighthouse Reserve. The Facebook page has been an absolutely fantastic way of getting our message out there.
After learning more about the council's plans and their tactics, I drove down the road to Queenscliff to meet with Chris Smythe. He offered to give me some of his professional concerns about developing both the Point Lonsdale and Queenscliff Lighthouse Reserves.
The big problem we have along the coast is this squeeze between development from one side and now climate change on the other. We have a very narrow coastal reserve. And so lots of places, even like Point Lonsdale, have been built too close to the coast. And so you have this pressure now on that narrow strip. How do you protect the infrastructure behind? You build seawalls and groins and you put in promenades. But unfortunately, that takes away some of that natural component. It also tends to lose the beach because you have these huge reflection of waves coming off the wall, scouring out the beaches and taking the sand somewhere else. And so now along Point Lonsdale Beach and between there and Queenscliff, we have a continually extending seawall. And where you have the end of the seawall, you get what's called terminal scour. And so the sand dunes there are being eroded. Just how much longer we can look after that kind of area without putting more seawalls in is a question for debate. But it means that we lose that natural area.
After hearing so many compelling arguments for why the Lighthouse Reserve needs to be treated differently to the typical piece of undeveloped land, I really got thinking about what we could all be set to lose if it had its history disrespected by putting high-end modern development on it. While there's a million different things we could do to the Lighthouse Reserve, from leaving it untouched to building high-rise apartments on it, I think it's fair to say we should be celebrating what we have there rather than trying to turn the town into something it's not.
If there was an original P1 hut constructed at the front here, that would be good to have some of the historic memorabilia inside it and maybe a cafe. And around the walls you had explanations about what has gone on here.
Now my solution for that area is to say, well, let's remediate it. And if National Heritage can be established, that then becomes a tourist icon in itself.
Prosperity for Queenscliff and Point Lonsdale is very much tied to the quality of the lifestyle, the quality of the marine and coastal environment. If those qualities suffer, then it's hard to picture what Point Lonsdale and Queenscliff would look like. By maintaining the aesthetics, by maintaining amenity, by maintaining public open space, that's where the future of this town really lies.
I'm very confident that with the new council elections, that new councillors will come on board who will articulate their view to be more in line with community expectations, and that will see the end of the development. So I'm a complete lighthouse nut and I love that spot, and it's worth preserving.